This is SSPTV News, brought to you by Samsung Productions and the Hazleton Standard Speaker.
Part two of an interview about how to keep your loved ones and your home safe during strong storms next. Hello there, friends. I'm Ken Carr, and I thank you for watching today. Let's get to the local information. In today's news feature, we have part two of Lisa Sugart's interview with Schuylkill County Emergency Management Agency Coordinator John Matz about what to do during strong storms.
One of the big issues for people when anything like this happens is their pets. So they're always worried. And as we do remember, you had brought up the fact too that in Katrina, a lot of people did not want to leave because they wouldn't leave their pets. So that's also a concern to know what to do with your pets, correct?
It is. And if we're opening up a shelter, we expect that somebody's going to come in with pets. And once they relay back to us that, hey, we have people coming in with, you know, cats, dogs, whatever, we'll reach out to our county animal response team and say, hey, we need support sheltering animals. And they have several trailers that are available to be deployed. They have a group of dedicated volunteers that are just terrific, handling the pet needs, the needs of the pets that are in these shelters.
And you told me the best place we should go to make our own plan is ready.gov, that has all the information that we would need so we know what we can, you know, make for our family, because everybody's different with their needs, as you explained earlier.
The ready.gov is an easy place to go to. They have an abundance of information that covers every possible aspect of it. We need to plan. That plan has to take into account all of our situations. So, you know, do we have elderly? Do we have people with functional needs, children? And then also putting a kit together. Now, that kit may be that something that's going to help you get through that first 72 hours. So even if you're not leaving your house, you know, you need some water supply there. And they recommend several gallons of water per day per person. In our house, I usually handle that with the cases of bottled water. Did we have enough food to last 3 or 4 days? And even as an emergency manager, I don't overdo it. But I do go over to the counter and I say, I open up the cabinet and say, yeah, I have 5 pounds of rice and there's a bunch of cans of beans and tuna fish. We may not be real happy living on, rice, beans, and tuna fish for 3 or 4 days, but we could do it. If I could add one more thing, just so everybody understands how the process works. So 2 weeks ago or 3 weeks ago, Ida came through and we had flooding. We were probably within an hour of, if the rain hadn't stopped, we would have had severe flooding, but fortunately it did. And that was averted. But there were people that had flooded basements. So their first version sort of is, hey, when's FEMA coming? We need to be able to, one, take care of ourselves. Part of that is flood insurance, because of course your homeowner's insurance will not usually typically cover floods. So you have to get flood insurance. And people say, oh, flood insurance is expensive. Or we also hear that they say, oh, my agent said you can't get flood insurance. We can't get flood insurance. Yes, you could. Everybody in the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania could get flood insurance. It's a national program. So that's one thing. You may not like to pay the bill for it, but certainly if you have a mortgage on your house, your lender is going to require that you have flood insurance. So the flood insurance is the first part. The second part is taking steps to try to minimize the amount of flooding, the impact that the flooding may do. So, there's been people that they put their furnaces up a couple blocks, up on a couple blocks. They've, moved their washer and dryer up. There's been some cases where people have actually removed their electrical panels from their basement and moved to the first floor. So there's less opportunity for that to be damaged. And I think that's all, some good starts. But one of the things that, we've been, like Schuylkill County Emergency Management, we deal with all of the 67 municipalities in Schuylkill. We expect them to feed us information so we gain that situation awareness of what's going on in Schuylkill. And then we, in turn, pass that information off to Pennsylvania Emergency Management, and they're collecting information from all of the 67 counties. So they know what's, you know, after a bit, they know what's going on in the Commonwealth. And then that gives them the opportunity to maybe look back to FEMA and say, hey, we have a substantial number of people who are impacted. And that is what is the determining factor of whether they go for a presidential disaster declaration.
Today's news feature is brought to you by Frankie's Pizzeria and Restaurant in downtown Hazleton. For more information on their specials, hours, and where you can find their delicious tavern pizza, you can call 570-454-6000, or you can visit their Facebook page.
West Hazleton police are looking for two males who robbed Pantry Quick at 16 North Broad Street around 9:30 on Wednesday night. No one was injured and an undetermined amount of cash was stolen. One of the males had a machete-type knife. One suspect is described as white with a brown and tan hemp-style sweatshirt, light blue jeans, and white sneakers, and the other is light-skinned, wearing a black zip-up sweatshirt, red bandana, black basketball shorts, and black slide-style shoes. Anyone with information can contact the West Hazleton Police Department by calling 911.
Time now for weather on SSPTV News.
Here's our forecast from the National Weather Service on Friday. Mostly sunny with a high near 60 degrees. Friday night, mostly clear with a low around 43 degrees. Saturday, sunny with a high in the mid-60s. Saturday night, partly cloudy with a low around 52 degrees. Sunday, a 40% chance of showers after 3 p.m. Partly sunny with a high near 66 degrees. Sunday night, showers likely, a 60% chance of precipitation, mainly between 9 p.m. and 3 a.m. Mostly cloudy with a low around 57 degrees. Monday, showers likely, mainly after 3 p.m. 70% chance of precipitation. Mostly cloudy with a high near 69 degrees. Monday night, a 70% chance of showers, mainly before 9 p.m. Mostly cloudy with a low around 55 degrees. It's Cross Country Day on the SSPTV Standard Speaker Scoreboard. MMI's Wooby Kupski took first place in a cluster meet at MMI, but the Preppers lost to Pittston area. At that cluster meet, Hazleton area swept by Pittston area and Wilkes-Barre area, with Nick Hebel finishing fourth. North Schuylkill's Justin Williams was first across the line at the Spartans cluster meet, but they lost 2 of 3. We'll talk with Williams soon on SSPTV News. We'll also be speaking with Katie McCormick, Riley Schwalem, and Kaylee Roberts of the girls team at North Schuylkill. They swept their meet with Blue Mountain, Pottsville, and Lehighton, and that's huge as the Lady Spartans try to close in on the Schuylkill League Division I title. Hazleton area beat Pittston area and Wilkes-Barre area, with Jillian Wolk taking fourth place at the meet. The MMI girls beat the same two teams. Mary-Kate Kupski was sixth for the Lady Preppers. Grace Stegemerton placed first for Tamaqua as they took 2 of 3 at a meet. In girls volleyball, Marion swept Halifax, and Ashley Klitsch continues to pile up the assists. She had 23 in the win. In water polo, Chris Catrone led the Hazleton area boys past Exeter with 4 goals. Shastin Tahansky had 7 goals and 7 steals for the Lady Cougars. Still to come, stories on the Bloomsburg Fair and the Hazleton area high school girls golf team.
SSPTV News, what's in sincere condolences to the family and friends of David A. Smith of Hazleton. The Joseph A. Moran Funeral Home will announce the arrangements.
Tonight's obituaries are being brought to you in part by Harmon Funeral Homes and Crematory, with 2 locations in Rockland and in Drums. 570-384-3312 or 570-788-0977. And go to harmonfuneral.com.